evening from Washington, D.C., and thank you to those of you joining us from around the world for news from a Catholic perspective. I'm Lauren Ashburn. President Donald Trump goes on a 50-tweet attack, including saying the media is blaming him for Friday's mass shooting in New Zealand. White House staff are defending the president, saying he's not a white supremacist, and condemning the attack against Muslims. We will have the latest on the attacks in just a few minutes, but first, White House correspondent Mark Irons reports. Good evening, Mark.
Good evening, Lauren. That's all been just part of the last 48 hours for the president. He's also starting his week fresh off a St. Patrick's Day that included going to church and criticizing the late Republican Senator John McCain. The president accused McCain of releasing a document at the center of the Russia investigation. The president writing, "So it was indeed just proven in court papers, last in his class, John McCain that sent the fake dossier to the FBI and media, hoping to have it printed before the election." Ken Starr, the independent counsel who investigated President Clinton, had previously said, "If the claim were true of Senator McCain, it would be a very dark stain." President Trump went further, tweeting about McCain's support of Obamacare. He had far worse stains than this, including thumbs down on repeal and replace after years of campaigning to repeal and replace. The senator's daughter, Meghan McCain, tweeting back, "No one will ever love you the way they loved my father." White House senior advisor Kellyanne Conway also praised McCain's service today while defending President Trump. She warned against cherry-picking his tweets.
"I know the man I work for, and I know how he is to a boss for me, and I know what he's trying to do for this country, and I see him publicly, but then privately with people, and how he's trying to help a lot of Americans and has this great economy."
Sunday, the president heard a sermon, in part, condemning hate speech. He and the First Lady made a rare appearance at St. John's Episcopal Church across from the White House. The Reverend preached against attacks on people of faith, including the Muslim community in New Zealand.
"Whenever we overhear or oversee hateful slurs against other people, perhaps we need the holy courage to call them out."
The First Lady's office tells us both the President and First Lady Melania Trump thought the service at St. John's was beautiful, and they went because they simply wanted to attend church. Lauren?
Mark, this week the President's budget is being released in its entirety. What are his priorities?
Well, we know presidents rarely pass their budgets, but a senior administration official tells us an unwavering commitment to keeping taxpayer funds from paying for abortions will be reflected in the fully released budget details. Lauren.
White House correspondent Mark Irons. Thank you, Mark.